Public speaking is something most people try to avoid and even dread. At times in my life, I have found myself having to deliver a speech and therefore I needed to learn the best way of doing this. In this presentation, I will share with you what I've learned from reading many books about public speaking, advice which has helped me to successfully deliver these speeches. I will call this, Public Speaking Training for Beginners. These public speaking tips will help minimize your fear of public speaking. Many people get very nervous before and during their presentation or speech. This can have a negative effect on their breathing and can leave them out of breath. When you feel nervous, it is a good idea to remember to take regular breaths when talking. In my opinion, you should be looking to breathe every 6 to 8 words. The nerves will make your muscles contract and can make your chest feel really tight. This is a natural reaction and it is a good idea to take a few deep breaths before starting your talk to help you to relax. When you start your public speaking, I would suggest that you have a focal point in the room, which can act to give you inspiration. This could be a picture at the back of the room or a window. At times you may lose your focus and may forget what you want to say. This focal point can help to get you back on track. I try not to look at the eyes of the people in the audience when I give a public speech, as this can put me off. I want them to think that I am not, as it can be a sign of nerves if they think that I am not able to. What I tend to do is to look at an area on their forehead which obviously is not their eyes but which has the effect that I am still looking at them. That's a bit funny, isn't it? Even though I do plan what I am going to say, I do not plan it word for word. Instead, I write down key words or key subjects on paper which I keep in my pocket in case I need to look at it. This will ensure that I do not forget what I want to say and also allows me to ad-lib. The speech will also hopefully not sound so robotic and boring as it might have if I had memorized it word for word. I always like to start off the public speech with a short joke, which can then act as an icebreaker. I remember a speech I gave a few years ago. It was my last day at the company where I worked. The co-workers in the office had bought me some leaving presents. I then had to say a few words of thanks to them. I knew many weeks in advance that I would have to give this speech and I have to say, it did cause me quite a bit of stress. The speech itself would only have to last for about 10 minutes and would be in front of around 50 people. This was how I started the talk. I would like to thank everybody who has contributed to my presence, and anybody who did not put, I will see you outside later. This was quite a pathetic joke, however a couple of people did laugh. This gave me a bit of extra confidence and helped to relax me. I also advise people to talk a bit slower than they normally do when they have to deliver a public speech. This has helped me tremendously over the years. Let us look at some easy steps which you can follow if you want to be good at public speaking. Throughout the history of human civilization, people have been expressing their confidence and strength, not only by force, but also by the noble art of public speaking. The orators of ancient Greece were highly respected and valued in the community. Likewise, today's world leaders are admired and esteemed when they have the power to address the public with poison conviction. Such a high regard for public speaking makes the average person cringe at the idea of talking in front of an audience, no matter how big or small the size. Whether giving a toast at a wedding or delivering a speech to a large assembly, most people make a big deal about public speaking and try to avoid it as much as possible. But public speaking should not cause such a big fuss. Challenging as it may be, public speaking can be done with a few simple guidelines. Before making the speech, do your preparation. Like any other endeavor, public speaking requires careful preparation to be successful. Many people would dream of having those inspired spontaneous speeches seen in movies, however, such scenes rarely happen in real life. To have at least a decent speech, one should plan well. Even the world's most famous leaders prepare for public addresses, and most even have teams to work on those plans. Well, even if one does not have a speech preparation committee, one can prepare for public speaking. First, one should know for what the occasion the speech is for. The Gettysburg Address would definitely not be appropriate for a wedding, thus, a speech has to fit the event where it will be delivered to. Second, one should examine the audience who will witness the speech. An assembly of academics would not take a perky speaker seriously. One should choose a suitable public speaking style based on the audience. Third, one should ponder what is being expected in the speech. A farmers' association would usually not be interested on a speech about the intricacies of beadwork. One should carefully study the subject matter to be tackled in public speaking. Making the speech, put your speech in writing. Again, dazzling spontaneous speeches rarely happen in real life. Most good speeches have been written before their delivery. While most noted public figures have speech writing committees, one can make a good speech even without the help of a team of ghostwriters. When writing for public speaking, one should carefully organize the contents of the speech. it usually pays well to begin with a very strong introduction. It is important to catch the audience's attention early to prevent them from being bored easily. Next, the body should be purposeful. The contents of the speech should relate well and support each other. It is not good to digress too much, though at times some deviations help attract attention when boredom arises. Lastly, one should make a conclusion that sticks to the mind. No matter how stirring a speech is, it is useless if the people forget it the instant they leave the gathering. Conclusions should give a concise but memorable recap of the body. The actual public speaking, deliver your speech with confidence. A written speech would not be consummated without the actual public speaking itself. This is the part most people are afraid of, but when proper planning and writing is done well, the delivery should follow easily. One must decide whether to speak from memory or to use notes. Beginners should benefit from a script or a guide. When one becomes more comfortable speaking in public, one can start relying from memory. Reading directly from a script can be quite boring for the audience, thus, it is important to keep constant contact with them. Speaking from memory is quite impressive, but it can be difficult to avoid missing some parts of the speech. Speaking with notes can be a good compromise so long as one is able to expound on the points well. The choice of how to deliver the speech depends entirely on the speaker, thus, it is important for one to weigh the options carefully. Learning more about public speaking. Several resources could help one do well in public speaking. Several books and articles about the topic have been published and they can well be accessed through the library or the bookstore. Many companies offer public speaking training, and such services provide in-depth courses that could help one speak well in public. There are also several articles and courses available through the internet, some of them are even posted for free. I hope this presentation helps you to deliver a quality public speech. We have come to the end of this inspiring presentation. How was it for you? If you have benefited from the information shared just now, please leave a comment below this video, share it and give it a thumbs up. Also remember to subscribe to this channel, and hit that notification bell so you will be the first to be notified when we upload new videos in the future. You have been a nice and attentive viewer. Keep up the good work and have a safe and peaceful day now. We'll be right back.